It's a great time to be a high-producing cow. Posilac One Step, Bovine Somatotropin by Monsanto.
The federal government basically rubber stamped it before they put it on the marketplace. The longest test they did for human toxicity was 90 days on 30 rats.
Posilac is the single most tested new product in history and is now available to you specifically so you can increase your profit potential.
And then either Monsanto misreported the results to the FDA or the FDA didn't bother to look in depth at Monsanto's own studies.
The scientists within Health Canada looked very carefully at bovine growth hormone and came to very different conclusions than the Food and Drug Administration in the U.S. did.
Monsanto's engineered growth hormone did not comply with safety requirements. It could be absorbed by the body and therefore did have implications for human health. Mysteriously, that conclusion was deleted from the final published version of their report.
They knew there were problems. They saw serious potential human health problems and they stood up in Canada and said, we're not going to approve this because we don't believe it's safe.
We have been pressured and coerced to pass drugs of questionable safety, including the RBST. I personally was very concerned that there's a very serious problem of secrecy, conspiracy, and things of that nature, and something needs to be done.
Then as time went, when they started to take sex hormones, both male and female, make a concoction of them, synthetic and natural, and then they started to inject them into cows. Actually, not just inject, they used to implant them behind the ears, large pellets, and they would remain for the rest of the life of the cattle. And that's the beef that people eat to this day. So that hormone remains behind there, and when the animal is slaughtered, the ear is cut off. And that ear is then boiled to make gelatin. And that gelatin, with concentrated hormones sitting there, now goes into making capsules, it goes into your gel, into your yogurt, into your ice cream, candy, and this is children are eating on a regular basis. What hormones do is they cause cancer and endocrine disruption. So puberty is affected, and you cannot determine the lowest level or the maximum level of something that causes cancer. One molecule attached to a cell can induce cancer. So you cannot determine the maximum residue limit. The second product that we're looking at, in a very big way, is antibiotics. Antibiotics, you can determine the residue, but the concern there is only allergic reaction in patients who may be allergic. That's not a very big concern. But there's a bigger concern. When you give antibiotic to every animal for life, those antibiotics, once they pass through the intestinal tract of the animal, which is full of trillions of bacteria of various kinds, and the antibiotic will kill off the good bacteria. It may leave some pathogenic bacteria. 75% of the antibiotic use is in farm animals.
Dr. Chopra sees a number of other threats to public health that are a result of the dysfunctional, industrialized global food system. Pesticides are one of them.
And they are now beginning to ban many pesticides. Sweden has just banned 80 pesticides. 80! There are hundreds of pesticides. And usually the Scandinavian countries take the lead on this. And so they're doing very well. When you slaughter an animal, only half the animal is meat, the rest is discarded. Now, what do you do with this? Because there's such huge slaughterhouses, they don't want to waste anything. They take the fat and so on, they process that and go into the soap or cream and the, all kinds of things. But the rest of the protein, they boil it up, they dry it, and then they feed it back to the animals. And that set up what's called bovine spongiform disease or mad cow disease, which then transmitted to people and called CJD and killed people. That was another item. And we have pesticides, we have hormones, we have antibiotics, we have slaughterhouse waste, and of course the genetically modified organism, GMOs. There was